Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Fahrenheit. So, today we're going to Agatha's house and see what the hell she will tell us, I guess.
This is the street her house is on. There's no point looking any further.
Okay, jeez. 41. Oh, this is the house that I'm supposed to go.
Here it is.
Will I kill her? Will he kill her? Who knows? Maybe it's unlocked. Of course it is. How could a creepy house be locked?
Is there anyone here?
And there's birds also. Oh, there's a card in here.
Old plates on the shelf.
Can I look in her fridge?
Nothing in particular. Are those crows in the cages?
Well, they don't sound like crows.
Is anyone at home?
Watch her be like dead. And then we'll be blamed for that.
Candlesticks, an old grimoire. Weird atmosphere. A stuffed crow.
She really likes crows.
Sheets on all the furniture, as if the house hasn't been lived in for a long time.
Wait a second.
Ooh. Stuffed owl.
Okay.
Are you Agatha?
Why do you want to talk to Agatha?
Help.
I was told that she could help me.
Help you? Tell me, who on this earth doesn't need a little help?
Who does that to a blind person? Like,
one
really?
One need not have eyes to see. Be kind, young man. Push me over to my birds. It'll be more comfortable for us to talk over there.
Sure. Yeah, let me just take her cross. Because she doesn't need it. The way he opened the door. By just slamming her into it. Well, you know what I mean. Wait a second. This way. I'm lost.
The bird is such a unique animal. Can spend its entire life locked up in a cage and yet still keep on singing away. What brings you here, young man? Tell me, what is your cage like?
I killed a man. It was like I was possessed. I watched it all happen, but I had no control over my actions.
Sounds like a rather commonplace story to me. Don't you think that it might simply be because you've gone mad?
Of course. You don't even know me. You've no reason to believe me. I'm sorry for having bothered you. I shouldn't have come.
In the cupboard, you will find a little bag of seeds. Be a good boy. Feed some to my little darlings, will you?
Be a good boy. Feed the seeds. Okay, There's an awful lot of seeds in that little bag. Do I have to speak with her?
Do you have any memory of what could have triggered your loss of control? Did you drink something, hear a sound, or see an image which seemed out of the ordinary?
I have no idea. In fact, I can't remember anything that happened to me from the time I entered the place to when I woke up again afterwards.
Have you experienced any other strange manifestations since then? Have you had any odd dreams or visions?
Yes. I see things as if the reality in front of me was deforming, becoming horrible.
Are you able to attach anything concrete to your visions, such as a symbol or sign, maybe a word?
When I regained control of myself after the murder, this symbol had been cut into my wrist with a knife.
A snake. Two open jaws. Oh, dear God.
What does it mean?
There's only one way for me to be sure. Please, push me into the sitting room.
Okay. I can make her head spin. This just looks weird. Okay, I should just...
You'll find some candles in one of the cupboards. Take them and place them in the candle holders. There should be some matches in the kitchen. Go find them and light the candles.
Kitchen, matches, candles... I forgot. Half of the things she said. Now, where did you say the candles were? Oh, that knife should be
here. An old wood stove. The coffee pot is still hot. An old sink.
Can I light them now? The way he places the candle is just... It's like thump! Candle in hole. Okay, the last one.
Perfect. We're almost ready to begin. Turn off the light, close the curtains, and sit down next to me.
Excuse me, could you tell me again what I'm supposed to do?
Turn off the light. Close the curtains and sit down next to me.
I didn't turn off the light. I mean, it's dark in here, so I assumed it was turned off. I don't know. That did nothing.
The only way to understand what has happened to you is to try to go deep into your unconscious memory. Whoever it was that forced you to commit this murder has erased himself from your memory. But there still must be a trace in your unconscious. I can help you to locate it. It's an exhausting ceremony, and there's always a risk involved. Do you, or do you not wish to try it?
Yes, I do.
Give me your hands. Now, close your eyes. I want you to empty your mind and open wide the doors to your unconscious. And let me enter there. That's it. We're still together. Lucas, are you there?
Yes.
I want you to return to the restaurant just before the events began. Evacuate all extraneous thoughts and wander freely.
Oh, I thought the game crashed.
Where are you, Lucas?
I'm standing outside the restaurant.
I want you to enter the restaurant now.
I've gone into the restaurant.
What do you see?
I see some customers. And I see the waitress.
Can you see the table where you were sitting?
I'm looking. There's a police officer. He's sitting at the counter.
Concentrate, Lucas. Now, walk to your table.
Standing next to my table, but it's empty.
You haven't arrived and sat down there yet?
Yes, I have. My meal is already on the table. I think this is when I murdered him.
Stay calm, Lucas. I want you to tell me exactly where you are.
I'm in the restroom, and so is the other man.
What's he doing?
He's urinating. He doesn't suspect anything.
And you, Lucas? Where are you?
I don't know. I can't see myself. There I am. I was in a toilet stall. Oh my God. I'm holding a knife. He doesn't see me.
Calm yourself, Lucas. Keep your concentration.
I can't control my steps. I'm walking up behind the man. He doesn't see me. I don't want to. I don't want to, but I can't stop myself.
I want you to re-enter the restaurant. But now, it is prior to going into the toilet stall. Do you understand, Lucas? Before.
Oh, I failed.
It's essential that you keep your concentration, Lucas. You must empty your mind of all thoughts. Let's begin again. Where are you now?
I'm in the restaurant dining room again.
Are you sitting at your table?
Yes, I am. I can see myself.
What are you doing, Lucas?
I'm eating. I'm eating and reading a book.
A book?
Yes. Shakespeare. The Tempest.
What else do you see?
As I told thee before, I am subject to a tyrant. A sorcerer. that by his cunning hath cheated me of the island.
What did you say?
It's a passage from Shakespeare's Tempest. That's what you're reading, is it not?
Yes. Someone's coming toward me. A man.
Who is it? A customer?
I don't know. I think so. I can't see his face.
And what does he say to you?
I don't know. I can't remember.
You must concentrate, Lucas. You need to remember.
It's one of my favorite books. A shame so few people read Shakespeare these days. Would you mind if I sat down for a moment?
Ah, it's just that... The man sat down at my table and... Now the waitress is coming.
Sir?
A coffee, please.
The waitress... It's as if she didn't see the man, like he was invisible.
So much has been written about the Tempest, especially concerning the theme of magic.
And now, what's happening, Lucas?
I don't know. The man gives off a very strange energy. It's hard to describe.
Go on, Lucas. What happens after that?
Do you believe in the power of magic?
No, I don't. Listen,
You're wrong. You know there's much more to our universe than can be perceived by the naked eye.
Your coffee, sir.
Thanks, Kate.
The waitress has brought him his coffee. But she's talking to me as if I was the one who ordered it. She doesn't know that he's there. She can't see him.
And now what's happening?
Listen, I don't want to be rude, but I'd rather eat alone.
Oh, this is when he possessed me, right?
I'm paralyzed. I can't feel my body. I can't move.
The man, Lucas. Where is the man?
He stood up. He's gone out. He's in my head now. He controls me.
Follow the man, Lucas. Hurry. I command you to follow that man closely.
He's going out the rear door.
Follow him. Your mind and his are now linked. You can see what he sees.
Well?
You know who that man was, don't you, Agatha?
Of course
no,
she knows.
I don't know. I'm not sure who he is.
Yes, you do know
She's
who
lying.
He is. You understood it all as soon as you felt the scars on my arms. What do these symbols mean, Agatha? Tell me what that man's done to me!
You should go now, Lucas. There's nothing more that I can do for you.
You could at least explain what the hell's happening to me! He made me kill a man! I want to know! I need to know!
I have to verify certain things. There's nothing more I can tell you today. Come back tomorrow night at the same time. I'll explain more then.
Well, she told us nothing. Okay, Lucas or Carla? Let's select her. See what the hell she's doing. Oh, she's naked. Okay, can I turn off the music? It's... She has teddy bears in her room. Okay. How do I turn off the music?
Sure took your time.
I was in the shower. What do you got?
I got nothing. Dead end. Impossible to ID the page marker found in the book from the restaurant. It's got a series of numeric codes written on it, but it just looks like a lot of numbers to me. I thought you might have some ideas.
Why don't you fax it to me? I wasn't tired anyway. I'm sure it'll make for good bedtime reading.
Okay, I'll send it now. If you get any brainstorms, give me a ring. I'll be here for a while. Tonight's gonna be a long one.
Okay, talk to you later, Tyler.
Okay, now I have to get her dressed, I guess. Where's her room again? Or can't I? Okay, now I feel better, because it felt weird when she was naked. I don't know. Okay, now what the hell am I supposed to do now? Can I use the bathroom? Apparently I can. That book. Can I use it? Nope. Can I eat that food? Nope. Might as well look for some cards, I guess. And she has duck soup. What the hell is with the duck soup? And she has Nutola, or whatever that was. The names in this game. A lot of milk, yogurt, I don't know. This laptop looks like it would be, you know, in The Sims. And the secret agent career or something like that, you know? We already read that. And we already... read this, I think.
Who could that be at this hour? I'm not expecting anyone.
I was feeling kind of bored, and thought as my official friendly neighbor you'd agree to share my boredom. And this excellent bottle of French Chablis.
In my capacity as your friendly neighbor, I wouldn't think of refusing your boring invitation or your excellent wine, Tommy.
I imagine that even a die-hard bachelorette like yourself must have some wine glasses around here somewhere.
I think I do have some. Somewhere. Sit down, Tommy. I'll find him.
Now, where does she keep them? Definitely not in the drawer with the duck soup. Why is it so hard to... Okay. There we go. This seems really awkward.
A toast?
All right. What to?
To love. What else?
I'll drink to that. Are you with anyone?
Well, actually, I did meet someone 2 weeks ago. He's very real and very nice. And he works in a bank, too. I think this time it could turn into something serious.
Is he that guy?
Are you still single? What's a beautiful girl like you waiting for? Go find yourself a nice guy. If there's one thing New York has lots of, it's handsome men.
I don't know. I guess the desire is just not there. My last romantic experiences were total disasters. I'm not ready for anything, or anyone, just yet.
And you, how are you? Business seems good. Every day in the papers they're writing about the rise in crime. At least you must feel useful.
Not especially. You know, when you make your rounds and see 10-year-old kids in the street, stoned on whatever, waving guns around, it makes you feel pretty useless. There's more and more kids on the streets, and We just don't have any concrete response to the problem, other than prison. Sometimes it gets to me, and I feel depressed.
Enough small talk. Look at what I brought.
Tarot cards?
I'm going to read your future.
You mean you know how to use those things?
My grandmother was a psychic. She taught me how to read the cards when I was just a kid.
Is your grandmother
Agatha?
She handed
down her seeing powers to me. It really works,
Why do I feel
know?
Like she is?
What the cards foretell always come to pass. Let's see if you're going to meet your true soulmate or if you're going to die as a wrinkled old maid.
Okay, Mr. Gypsy. Tell me what I'm supposed to do.
It's easy. First, take the cards and mix them up. Take two cards.
Oh, I can choose. I want this one. How do I? Okay. Oh, she's naked. And maybe, you know what, let's do this one.
There's going to be a dark period, an escape, and terrible danger. Take two more cards.
Oh, God. I don't know what the hell I'm doing.
You're not alone. You're following someone, and he is disturbing. He hides a heavy secret. Take two more cards, please.
Why do I feel like it's always the same curse, no matter what you choose?
There is a curse. Great suffering and fear. I see dark death and distress. Yes, just come to me whenever you need cheering up. Seriously, I'm sorry, Carla. This is not turning out to be as much fun as I thought.
It's okay, Tommy. Let's see what horrors my destiny holds for me. Here are two more cards.
One child. Two destinies. A path toward life, the other path toward death. Carla, I think we'll stop there. I'm sorry, I don't know what happened. It's the first time I've ever read this sort of thing in the cards. Usually don't express anything like this.
Don't apologize, Tommy. It's just a silly game. I never believed in fortune-telling anyway.
Well, I've got to get home. It's late. Good night, Carla.
Good night, Tommy. It was real nice talking. Don't wait so long next time, okay?
I promise.
Okay. Now she probably feels depressed. Can I pick those cards up and
is my future
throw them away? I don't know.
You mentioned a child. I don't believe in this stuff, but it's always a little scary, whatever you think of it.
Guess I can control Tyler.
Normally, I don't like leaving Sam home alone, especially now. But this bookmark had me intrigued. I had a gut feeling that I was holding the key that would identify our killer. I felt like I was closing in on him, and I wasn't about to go home to sleep until I figured out what this paper meant.
Okay, so I'll end this episode right here, everybody. I do hope you enjoyed it. We will continue the next one. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. I hope you have a great day. Goodbye.